Take three. Bass Interpreter here, coming at you with my third take today. Hopefully this gets posted, because, you know, I'm having one of those days where I keep making small, stiff mistakes. Anyway, Rick James, you know, Super Freak. Ooh. Or, you know, those who grew up in the 90s, it's, you know, MC Hammer. Stop! Hammer time! Then, of course, then you talk about that, and you gotta talk about... Stop, collaborate, and listen. His eyes from a brand new invention, something. Got a hold of me tightly. Anyway. Rick James, Super Freak, bitch. Hope you enjoy. Biatch. Say the greatest takeaway from Super Freak is on that main part. So remember, it's gonna be so. I'm doing like a hammer on and a pluck at the same time, and then doing the same thing. So you want it to have a little bite, but you want to have funk too. You don't want it to be all metal. You don't want it to be too much bite. You want just enough bite where it's got that. And then you just play it normal. Obviously, there's different methods of playing it, depending on what you feel comfortable with. A A lot of times when I'm looking up stuff online, a lot of bass players tend to tap things as if they're a guitarist, and I don't understand why. There are songs where you need to go high, you know. Oh my God, it's been so long since I played that song. But anyway, you get my idea. There are some songs where you have to go up high, but you're bass player, people. Playing the bass. Boom. Have a great day. Love, peace, harmony. Boom, boom.